How do you evaluate the 5G deployment around the world?
Actually, it is not just the devices. Actually, I would like to say in just the 1 year, you can see all of the world standards, spectrum, and also networks already have 5G is ready. I think the first for spectrum, I think till the end of 2021, over 70 countries will allocate their 5G spectrum. This is really a foundation for all the 5G industry. Also for standards, I think next year, the Q2, the release 16 will be completed. This new standards will deliver the better performance and also better use for all the industry in this area. Also, when we talk about devices, till now, there are 130 devices and also modules already been launched in all of the world. Also, they are becoming more affordable. So it means all the users can buy this, right? No any problem. Also, when we talk about the 5G smartphones, at around $500 now, till today, is available. But we estimate till next year, I think the second half, the smartphones at less $350 will hit this market. I think this is fantastic for these areas.
What do you expect about the 5G deployment in Brazil? I know we still have the spectrum auctions, but we do have some telecom operators conducting trials.
Yes. As you know, next year, the Anatel will start to e-auction, probably in next year, the Q3. Also, in the past 2 years, we cooperate with Brazil operators like Vivo, Claro, TIM, also Oi, also Agar. We did some trial in their network. Also, this time in FutureCom, you can see in the Telco Transformation booth, we did the 4 trials with the operators. We did Vivo, like live sports broadcast based on 8K, and also Agriculture 4.0. We cooperated with Vivo, also with Claro. You can see we together to build a rowing boat. You can go there to experience the gaming. It's really amazing. Also with Oi, we together to build, like we call this FWA. It is the 5G wireless, the fiber. It's really amazing download speed over 1 giga. Also we cooperate together with the Safe City. Also with the team. We together to build an ARM machine. You can play with this machine the game. It is really, you can experience very low latency. This is really amazing. Thank you.
What is the role of 5G in boosting connectivity and in helping companies, all kind of industry, to develop new business models and to transform their industries, and including their companies, I would say?
Yes. Actually, you know, 5G is really revolutionary technology. And also, we need to think about this in a different way. 5G not only changes our life, also will change all the industries, will change all the society. 5G is really the enabler for the telco transformation. We can talk 3 areas. The first is the B2C, the market. You know, 5G will bring a transformative broadband, mobile broadband experience. We forecast till 2025, there will be 1.6 billion the users. Also in South Korea, they already launched this 5G business. The users really are willing to pay more money because the new services like AR, VR, also cloud, the gaming. Also, we did a lot of trial in Brazil. This really will happen. Also in the home broadband market, you can see in the world, European or Middle East or in China, a lot of operators will already launch this FWA service based on the 5G. Also in Brazil, I do believe, because in Brazil there are some reasons. It is very hard for some reasons, some cities, it's hard to deploy the fiber. But I think the 5G is a good option for home broadband service. The third for B2B. Actually, ultra-reliable network really can enable industries to go to the digital. The B2B the business is really different than B2C, because in B2B business, we can trust these services based on the SLA, like download or uplink the speed. Also, we can monetize by low latency. Also, we can monetize by reliability. It means all the operators need to rethink or redefine their business model. It really can happen.